Welcome to Carrizozo Music. Carrizozo Music is a nonprofit organization celebrating its 14th year, and it is dependent on grants, foundations, and your generous donations. Due to the COVID-19 pandemic, we have moved all of our music to a virtual platform for you to enjoy any day and any time from the comfort of your own safe place. Part of the mission of Carrizozo Music is to provide school outreach programs, including concerts, workshops, lectures, and demonstrations for the children of New Mexico, many of whom live in impoverished communities and never have the opportunity to experience this type of culture. Performances are funded in part by the New Mexico Humanities Council, New Mexico Arts, National Endowment for the Arts, Western Arts Foundation, Otero County Electric Cooperative Operation Roundup, Tularosa Basin Telephone Company, Zia Gas, and listener donations. Throughout the performance and afterwards, we will answer your questions via our email, carrizozomusic@gmail.com. All emails will be answered within 48 hours. Please visit our website to watch and listen to the many great performances we have in our performance library at carrizozomusic.org. Remember, donations from you, the viewer, are important to the success of this organization. Thank you.
Welcome to this concert of the Palmetto Winds Woodwind Trio, performed in West Stockbridge, Massachusetts, and presented by Carrizozo Music. Before we begin, I'd like to thank some very important institutions and individuals without whom we would not be able to present this concert. Our heartfelt thanks go to Western States Arts Federation, the National Endowment for the Arts, Carrizozo Music Incorporated, and viewers like you, who have all made generous donations. I'd like to introduce the musicians. My name is Catherine Hudgins. Also on clarinet is William Hudgins. And Wren Saunders plays bassoon. Thank you.
Divertimento. It is an Italian word that means pleasure or entertainment. Way back in the 18th century, when this divertimento that we are playing was written, people went to fancy parties and were very dressed up. There might have been live music, and the musicians might have played a brand new piece for the occasion. The word divertimento came to mean a type of music that was written for just such an occasion. Light and entertaining. It would have several separate sections called movements. We just played the first movement from Mozart's Divertimento number 3, and next we will play the slow movement of the same Divertimento. This slow movement has very calm and relaxing sounds. You might enjoy just closing your eyes and experiencing the calm feelings.
Thank you.
next piece is a minuet from this same Mozart divertimento. A minuet is one type of movement or section of a divertimento that was very popular in Mozart's time. Imagine your favorite music to dance to now, and you will understand how people in the 18th century enjoyed minuets. What makes a minuet special is its form. It starts out with a melody, and that section is repeated, followed by another melody, which is also repeated. These two melodies, which seem like similar sounding music, are known as the minuet section. Next comes the trio section. This music sounds a little different. When you listen, see if you notice a different mood in the trio than the two minuet melodies. After the trio, the original minuet music returns.
Thank you.
last movement that we will play from this Mozart divertimento is called a rondo. The name comes from a French word meaning round, because the music just keeps coming around to the same melody again and again. You will hear the first lively melody, and then a different section, and then the first lively melody again. This pattern keeps repeating. In this rondo, you will hear that original lively melody 5 times. Can you notice each time the melody returns?
But I wonder how many of you have heard that famous melody played on the bassoon. In my work as an arranger for this ensemble, I felt some pity on my bassoonist colleague for often having just a bass line or accompaniment to the clarinet melodies so much of the time. so I decided to give the bassoon a starring role.
Hi, my name is Wren Saunders and I play the bassoon. I play principal bassoon in the Plymouth Philharmonic in Massachusetts and in the Bangor Symphony in Maine. I first became interested in the bassoon in the second grade when a chamber ensemble came to my school and played a concert. There was a bassoon player, and when I saw that instrument, I knew I wanted to play it. Unfortunately, I wasn't able to play the bassoon until almost high school. I started on the violin in the third grade, and then I switched to the flute in the fifth grade. But once I started on the bassoon, there was no turning back. Eventually, I majored in music and became a professional bassoonist. The bassoon is a double reed instrument, and I'm going to show you how I make a reed. So I start with a piece of cane that looks like this. I'll bring it in close for you so you can see. Then I shave off the middle part of this cane and I shape it into something that looks like this. Then I fold this piece of cane in half and I round it out and I tie it together with string and wire. And then I cut the tip so there's a hole here in the middle. Then I can play it. First, the reed needs to be wet, so I put it in some water, and I wet it completely like this. When I blow into it, the two pieces of cane vibrate together. And it makes a pretty sound like that. Then I put it on my bassoon. So first I have to put my bassoon together. This part is called the boot joint. I have a bunch of keys that I play with my thumb. This one is called the pancake key. And as you can see, there are two holes here. And it goes down one side, and then there's a tube that connects the two sides together in the bottom underneath this cap. Then I put the wing joint in. These keys I play with my thumb. And then these keys in the front and holes I play with my fingers. Next is the long joint. These keys I play with my thumb, and these keys I play with my pinky. Next is the bell. And it just has one key here that helps me play the lowest note on the bassoon. Next is the vocal. And I put this in the top of the bassoon right here. Lastly, I put the reed on my bassoon. Now you'll notice that the bassoon is quite large. It's actually almost 20 pounds, and so it gets very heavy to hold. And so I need to use either a shoulder strap or a seat strap. So the shoulder strap goes over my shoulders like this, and I hook up the bassoon right here so that I don't have to hold it with my fingers. The shoulder strap holds up the weight. Now, the bassoon has a really wide range that it can play. So I can play really low notes. And I can go really high. Ensembles. Sometimes, because the bassoon plays really low notes, we're tasked with playing accompaniment or the bass lines. And I'll play a little bit of a bass line right now for you. Sometimes the bassoon gets to play beautiful melodies.
Thank you.
Hello, my name is William Hudgins, and I am the principal clarinetist of the Boston Symphony Orchestra. Playing clarinet in the orchestra is my full-time job. At the beginning of a week, I practice at home to learn my music well. And then for 2 days, the orchestra rehearses together all the music. On Thursday, Friday, and Saturday nights, the orchestra plays the concerts for the audiences. And then the next week, we start all over again with different music. When I started to play the clarinet in my school music program in the fourth grade, I had no idea that later in my life, playing music would be my career, and that I would travel all over the world playing concerts. The clarinet is a very versatile instrument. It can be played in small ensembles, in school bands and military bands, in jazz groups, and in orchestras. Do you know how the clarinet makes its sound? Well, like every other sound on earth, it has to have some kind of vibration. On the clarinet mouthpiece, up here at the top of the clarinet, we have a little piece of bamboo-like cane. We call this the reed. The reed is what vibrates and makes the sound. I'll show you the reed up close. It gets very thin at the top. That helps the vibration. Then, when we blow air into the mouthpiece just behind the reed, that reed starts vibrating like crazy. As the sound travels down the tube of the clarinet, I can open and close different holes, and depending on which ones, that determines whether I get high notes or low notes. Today on this video, most of the time you are seeing the most common clarinet, the B-flat clarinet. But the clarinet has a whole family.
Hello, my name is Catherine Hudgins, and I'm also a professional clarinetist. I play in large symphony orchestras and also in small chamber music groups. I'd like to show you two other members of the clarinet family.
She's holding in her left hand the A clarinet, and you can see that the A clarinet is a little bit taller or longer than the B flat clarinet. And now over in her right hand, she's holding the small piccolo E flat clarinet, and you can see that it's quite a bit different. It's very short compared to the B flat clarinet. Some people like to play the great big contrabass clarinet or the pretty big bass clarinet. We don't have them here today, but you can look them up on Google. Now, listen for a moment as Catherine plays a scale on the A clarinet, and then I'll play that same scale on the B flat clarinet, and then she'll come back and play a third time on the small piccolo E flat clarinet. It'll sound just a little different, even though we're using exactly the same fingers on the same keys on each instrument. See if you can tell the difference. Sometimes I like playing fast notes that go from the low notes up to the higher notes, like this. Our next trio piece in this concert is an arrangement of some music that Franz Schubert wrote for ballet dancers. Schubert lived in Vienna, Austria, and he wrote the music for this piece almost 200 years ago. I think it starts out as simple and happy music. It makes me think of how I felt when school was over and I was on my way home to play with friends. You can listen for the special bass line that Wren plays all by herself on the bassoon. And then look at Catherine, and you will see that she is playing the small E-flat piccolo clarinet. See if you can hear how it makes the group sound just a little bit different than the other pieces we played.
Thank you.